the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Again, it is a great joy and privilege for me, 2 weeks into my priesthood, to be here at the Church of the Holy Innocents, a spiritual home away from home for me throughout these years of formation, yet again amongst you all. And I pray our Lord and Lady grants me many more opportunities to come here frequently to pray the Holy Mass with you, and of course the great official prayer of the priest and monk, that of the Divine Office. So today, the Holy Mass this morning, it was offered according to the external solemnity of Corpus Christi, this great feast of the Church. Let's review the origins of this feast of the Church, for it might surprise us. We all know what the foundation, the center of our Catholic faith is. It's not the Holy Father in Rome, believe it or not, that might put you at ease these days, but it is the Holy Eucharist, first and foremost. It is our Lord's real and true presence in the Blessed Sacrament that is the center of the Catholic faith, that is our source of unity. It might surprise us then, that it took 12 centuries for a feast in the Church's liturgical year to be devoted solely to the Most Blessed Sacrament, the Holy Sacrament of the Altar. How did this feast come about? Well, there was a holy young woman named Juliana of Liege in Belgium, and she received visions, apparitions, of our Lord, and she had the recurring vision before she took the veil and entered the convent of a very full, bright moon with a dark spot on it. She did not know what this meant, and it took years of prayer before our Lord finally appeared to her to explain what this recurring vision of a very full, bright moon with a dark spot on it meant. And our Lord Jesus told Juliana, the holy nun, that in his eyes, the moon was like that of the Church's liturgical year. Very full, very bright, giving him great glory. But it had one dark spot on it. Something was missing. And that was a feast devoted solely to his real presence in the Most Holy Sacrament of the Altar, in the Blessed Sacrament. And he told Juliana that it was his divine and holy will that she make sure a universal feast devoted to our Lord's most holy body and most precious blood be instituted. She was just a simple nun in a convent. How could she ever see to it that a feast for the universal Church be brought about? She was so overwhelmed by this mission. Saint Juliana, now canonized, even shed tears of blood. Anxiety over so great a task. And she did not share the visions with anyone for 20 years. It took St. Juliana 20 years to muster up the courage to finally bring forth these visions to a priest. But this was according to providence, God's divine providence, because it was his plan that the visions wait in the recesses of her heart, only to be revealed when the right priest came into St. Juliana's life. And who was that right priest? Simply a young priest of her diocese, a cathedral canon. He became her spiritual director, and she told him of her visions. Years later, this simple priest was elected to the highest office in Holy Church, but to succeed St. Peter, and he took the name Urban IV, Pope Urban IV. And he never forgot, though she had since died, the visions of that holy nun to whom he was a confessor. And Pope Urban IV saw to it that our Lord's holy will be fulfilled, and he instituted the Feast of Corpus Christi to be universally celebrated the Thursday after Trinity Sunday, or as it can be extended to today, an external solemnity on the first Sunday after Trinity Sunday. Our Lord wanted this feast to extend devotion to him and to prepare Catholics for the great attacks that were to come against the holy doctrine of our Lord's real presence in the Eucharist. Of course, those attacks came in the Protestant Reformation, and they're with us today again, even within the Church. So great and so important is this feast for us, even unto this day, a great crisis of belief and devotion to our Lord's real presence in the Blessed Sacrament, which is why we so greatly need an expansion of devotion to our Lord's presence in the Eucharist through the form of the Mass that most cultivates this devotion and most cultivates belief in his real presence. And a final word about this great feast, now that we know a little bit of its origins. There's one aspect of it that is truly remarkable and is something we can give great, we can meditate upon very deeply. And that's this. Unlike the Feast of Christmas, which commemorates our Lord's birth some 2,000 years ago, unlike the Feast of Easter, which commemorates our Lord's resurrection some 2,000 years ago, unlike the Feast of the Ascension, which commemorates our Lord's ascension into heaven some 2,000 years ago, all those feasts of the Lord commemorating a historical event that happened long ago in the past, the great Feast of Corpus Christi celebrates a current event. It celebrates something that happens each and every day when the holy sacrifice of the Mass is offered upon the altar. It commemorates God's great love for us to come down from heaven at the words of a priest onto our altar, to feed us spiritually, to feed our souls, which is why it's so fitting that our Lord comes to us under the species of bread and wine, to feed our souls. And we are to behold God's great love for us in just a few moments in the monstrance. So let us give the great thanks to God for the faith of St. Juliana of Liege, for giving us a Holy Father like we had in Pope Urban IV, who gave us this great feast. And let us give great thanks to God and behold his love for us as we gaze upon the Blessed Sacrament just now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.